Jeff James wasn't expecting to be playing for HCC this year. In fact, when he left high school, he didn't expect to be a Dragon at all.
He was being recruited out of high school by Mount St. Mary's, and a good friend of mine who actually was my college teammate was the one who recruited him to Mount St. Mary's. And the whole Mount St. Mary's coaching staff, they left for Holy Cross. Couldn't get Jeff into Holy Cross. And then what happened was Jeff had a series of injuries and just kind of slipped through the cracks. So I went and saw Jeff at an open gym, met him, had good conversation with him, and was able to get him to come up. And he liked the campus, liked the school, and we were able to get him in here. He led us in points, rebounds, and assists. Then he ended up getting hurt about 6 or 7 games left in the regular season that first year.
A knee injury forced Jeff to miss the rest of that season, but he hoped to pick up where he left off the following season. That didn't happen.
He went down the second game of the season and broke a couple bones in his near his elbow.
I don't know if it was a jinx or what, but I felt like whenever I played, I kept getting hurt. So it was like a psychological thing, like, I'm going to get hurt. Like,
Jeff was out for the year, filling his time with diversions off the court.
For Dragon's Lair Update, this is Jeff James.
While planning his return to the court.
People get injured all the time, and they bounce back. So I just like, don't give up, just come back stronger.
Oh yeah, he come back strong. Like, even when he wasn't playing with us, I saw him in the gym always working, trying to get back.
Him dealing with the injuries, I think, motivated him to go harder and like really stay focused.
Physically was pretty good, but I've been more impressed with how he's come back mentally. He's been focused. He got a 3.0 in the classroom, which is what I'm most proud of about him. He flicked the switch at some point this season and started leading us.
As a player, Jeff picked up the reputation as the kind of guy who would rather boost his teammates' stats and put less emphasis on his own.
First of all, I think Jeff is probably the most talented player we have on the team, and I think the guys are aware of that. They see him for his size, handling the ball and making, you know, unbelievable passes.
He can pass really good.
When I was younger, I used to play with like older people, and when you're young, they'd be like, what are you doing? Don't shoot the ball. So I always was like, my job is to pass people the ball. I'm not a scorer, so I'm gonna pass the ball.
He has this jump shot, but he does not like to take the jump shot, and coaches tell him to take the jump shot all the time, but he drives to the basket.
Even though he's a big, he can still run the court like a point guard. He has ball handling. He can share the ball. He can finish layups, all that.
He'd rather get other players involved, so it's kind of contagious. To have a whole team that plays for each other, it really starts with him wanting to have other guys score.
With his unselfish attitude, along with his experience, Jeff easily became one of the leaders on the team.
To see somebody that talented making the sacrifices that he's making, it's admirable. The freshmen really, you know, want to be like him.
If I'm having a bad game, like in the first quarter, I'm not doing my job, he'll definitely get on my back, like, come on, Connor, you got this. And it just keeps pushing me, and that really helps me a lot.
His leadership extends to life off the court as well.
I got class with him. I think I've had class with him almost every semester I've been here, so he's always around.
We help each other with homework. I have 2 classes with Jeff. He helped me a lot, and I help him.
Me and Jeff, like, the way we play is very, very similar. So we, on the court and off the court, we have a close bond.
Jeff's also around for another person who might need some leadership.
I just had a son, so I feel like if I didn't go through this, I wouldn't be able to raise him as much, because I wouldn't know what it takes to be more mature. Whenever I feel like quitting, whenever I feel like I can't do it no more, I think of him and be like, I can't let him see me being a quitter. He needs to know his dad's gonna do whatever it takes.
So far, Jeff has been able to do whatever it takes to get to a 4-year college. He already has some scholarship offers and expects more.
I want to major in probably broadcasting or communications, because I still want to be a part of the game. I love talking about it. I love sports.
And I think that if he continues to lead and do the things that he's doing, I think he's going to be able to take his pick of what school he wants to go to. So we're just trying to find him the school of best fit. And he knows, and I know, that getting his degree from a 4-year school is the main goal.
Jeff credits Coach Melkinson and the rest of the coaching staff for helping him mature and do what he needs to do to live his dream of going to a 4-year school. And he's hoping he'll make them proud wherever he ends up. I am Chris Oviedo for Dragon's Lair Update.